I'm just doing what I gotta do. Fly than the rest of them. Still got my Nike boots. Fly than the rest of them. Fly than the rest of them. Fly than the rest of them. Still got my Nike boots. Fly than the rest of them. 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 Still got my Nike boots. 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 The revolution will proceed. Unification, the DMV, I will achieve indeed. I decree I'm forming a new alliance. Suppose the one poisoning the minds, they lying. I am only a fighter in the form of a writer, in the form of a poet. Potency in the mic.
Through in the trade of war, I have slain men, yet do I hold it very stout. Ooh, the conscience to do contrived murder. I look antiquity, sometimes do I service. 9 or 10 times I had thought love yerked him more under the ribs.
'Tis better as it is.
Nay, but he prated and spoke such scurvy and provoking terms against your lover that with the little godliness I have, I did full hard forbear him. But I pray you, sir, are you first married? Be assured of this, that the Magnifico is much more beloved and hath in his effect a voice potential as double as the Duke's. He will divorce you or put with you upon your or put upon what restraint and grievance the law will give him cable.
Let him do his spite. My services which I have done this signory shall out tongue his complaints. 'Tis yet to know which when I know that boasting is an honor, I shall promulgate. I fetch my life and being from men of royal siege, and my Demetrius may speak unbonneted to as proud a fortune as this that I have reached. For now, Iago, but that I love the gentle Desdemona, I would not unhoused, free condition, put into circumscription, and confined for the sea worse. But look, what lights come yond.
Those are the raised father and his friends you were best go in.
I must be found my parts, my title, and my perfect soul shall manifest me rightly. Is it there?
By Janus, I think no.
The servants of the Duke and my lieutenant. The goodness of the night upon you, friends. What is the news?
I discreet you, General, and here quiets your haste post haste spirits even on the instant.
What's the matter?
Something from Cyprus, as I may define. It is a business of some heat. The galleys have sent a dozen secret messengers this very night at one another's heels, and many of the consuls raised and met are at the Duke's already. You have been halty called for. When being not at your lodging to be found, the Senate hath spent about 3 several guests to search you out.
'Tis well I am found by you. I will but spend a word here in the house and go away with you.
Ancient, what makes me here?
If he tonight hath boarded a land carrack, if it prove lawful prize, he's made forever.
I do not understand.
Yeah.
He's married.
To who?
Yeah.
Married to. Oh, come captain. Will you go?
Have with you.
Here comes another troop to seek for you.
Off into the...
It is Barbantia. General, be advised. He comes to bad intent.
Hola, stand there.
Signor is the ball.
Down with him, thief!
Ah! You, Roderigo, come, sir, I am for you.
Keep up your bright swords, for the dew will rust them. Good senor, you shall move command with years than with your weapons.
That foul thief, whore hast thou stowed my daughter? Damned as thou art, thou host enchanted her, for I'll refer me to all things of sense. If she in chains of magic were not bound, whether a maid so together fair and happy, so opposite to marriage, that she shunned the wealthy coral darlings of our nation, would ever have to incur a general mook run from her guardage to the sooty bosom of such a thing as thou, to fear, not to delight. Judge me, the world, if it's not gross, incensed that thou hast practiced on her with foul charms, abused her delicate youth with days of drugs or materials, that weakens motion, I'll have disputed on. 'Tis probable and palpable to thinking. I therefore apprehend and do attach thee.
Thee for an abuser of the world, a practicer of the arts inhibited and out of warrant. Lay hold upon him. If he do resist, subdue him at his own peril.
Hold your hands, both you of my inclining and the rest. Were it my cue to fight, I should have known it, without a prompter. Whither will you that I go to answer this your charge?
To prison, till fit time of law and course of direct session call thee to answer.
What if I do obey? How may the Duke be therewith satisfied, whose messengers are here about my side upon those present business of the state, to bring me to him?
There's no composition in the news that gives them credit.
Indeed, they are disproportioned. My letters say 107 galleys.
And mine, 100.
Not on just account, as in these cases, where the aim reports tist off with difference, yet they all confirm a Turkish fleet and bearing up to Cyprus.
Nay, it is possible enough to judgment. I do not secure me in the air, but the main article I do perform in fearful sense.
What ho, what ho, what ho?
A messenger from the galleys.
Now what's the business?
The Turkish preparation makes for Rhodes, so as I bid report to the state by Signor Angela.
How you say by this change?
This cannot be, by no assay of reason. 'Tis a pageant to keep us in false gaze. When we consider the importance of Cyprus to the Turk, and let ourselves again but understood that it is more facile question bearer, for that it stands not in such warlike brace, but altogether lacks in the abilities that Rhodes is dressed in. If we make thoughtful of this, we must think that the Turk is unskillful to that the least which concerns him first, neglecting an attempt of case and again to wake and wage a danger profitless.
Nay, in all confidence, this is not for Rhodes.
Here's more news.
The Ottomites, reverent and gracious, steering with due course toward the Isle of Rhodes, have there enjoined them with an after fleet.
Ay, so I thought. How many, as you guess?
Of 30 sail, and now they do restam their backward course, bearing with frank appearance their purposes toward Cyprus. Signior Montano, your trusty and most valiant servitor, with his free duty, recommends you thus, and prays you to believe him. 'Tis certain then in Cyprus, Marcos Lusicos, is not he in town?
He is in Florence.
Write from us to him, post haste dispatch.
Here comes Barbantio and the valiant Moor.